It was last year. It was a winter morning, sunny winter morning, when my friend called. Actually, ex-colleague called. And he said, "Hey, Arturs, there is a customer who has an issue with their project, software implementation project. And they are looking for an expert who could look into that project and help them solve the issues." So I said, yes, why not? And next day, basically, I went to the customer's site and I talked to the guys. There were two guys sitting. There was project manager and a member of the board. And while talking to them, I could feel and see the confusion and frustration in their project and in their behavior. So what did they tell me? They told me the usual stuff, the problem that they had the budget overrun and the deadlines have been missed. So the budget was actually overrun 10 times and the deadline was like 5 times or something like that. So usual stuff, right? Like every day. Yeah, okay. It was a software implementation project. So basically the customer was the company, the business company, and then there were vendors who came to this company and offered their services as a software developers to develop the software for business process automation for all the processes they have in the company. It was a quite big customer, around 1,000 employees for Latvia, big, okay? So another thing, they told that they don't really trust the vendor anymore because they don't know if they can trust their promises. They promised one time already, and then there is another time, another plan they bring up to the table, and they ask if they can trust them. So they gave me a big pack of emails, printed out emails between the two sites, showing that there has been a communication, they have agreed to a lot of things, but none of those things actually worked out. So the vendor was not listening to them. And they gave me an email with 1,000-page specification document about what has been done until now. So I took those two packs of documents, and I was ready basically to go home, do my auditing and thinking things, and do a judgment in the name of good project management practices. And so I did. So what did I find out? It was dark waterfall. And so far, it was splitted in the following waterfall-y phases: analysis, design, development, UAT preparations, all the data migrations, and all the other stuff that goes here, and of course, go live at the end. They have done analysis and design so far. And that was this big document that was outdated by now. It's 6 months old. They started it 6 months ago, all those writings. When I talked to the employees, to the business, they said, yeah, I don't remember what I wrote there. I might need to check that out. I went through the document myself, well, just randomly. Some of the topics were written in very good detail, to the really, really down specifics. Some topics will be written like, need to talk about that later. And that was actually in the document. So, and based on these documents, of course, they did estimates for the plan and for the budget and everything else. So what do you think? Is it a good document? Useful? Yes? Exactly, very good document. Lot of paper. So another thing, I saw the big communication gap. The emails, I didn't read any of those emails though, but I could see that there is a problem in the communication between the two parties. And of course, there was two goals, two teams. There was vendor team who was doing the software programming and implementation, and then there was a customer team who was, you know, doing, telling their pain and expecting a good working software. But they didn't have a common goal. The vendor wanted to deliver the software, or basically develop it and drop it at the customer, and they don't care about anything else. Well, the customer, what the customer wants? Yes, solve the problem, exactly. So, and another thing, there was no framework of project management at all. So I couldn't see what is the methodology or way of thinking that actually project is done. And these are the basic metrics. Not metrics, but basic takeaways that I had. And they asked, okay, what to do? I told them, well, you have all those problems, so basically you should try Scrum. And I said, okay, let's try Scrum. We were thinking about it, but somehow we didn't make it so far. So they created a new project plan where they took the two phases, so it's kind of a smaller pilot and then the big everything, and they divided it in 2 week sprints. Kind of fine, right? Then I did a training, few day training about Scrum, what is Agile, a way of thinking, what is Scrum. We did some working agreements, some blah, blah, blah. Well, the usual stuff you would do in a training for a specific team. And the team was 2 developers, 2 analysts, and maybe some more people, more developers, yeah, and a lot of business people. Yes, we did the training. We set up the event schedule for Scrum events. We also set up Jira to do the all the backlog thing. Yep, we used the previous backlog there. And the Scrum was up and running. They were agile, we were agile, we were super agile there. So what else we did? Actually, they created the kind of a roadmap. So basically, they just said all the epics or functionalities, groups of functions, divided in months. So you can see what will be done when by budgeted time. And then the project went on. So that was a phase one where we created the EVM. Those who have learned classic project management, that is earned value management, where you can actually see what was a planned value and what is the earned value based on are we behind the schedule or are we faster than the schedule. Okay, so here we see that it was fine in the beginning, but only because they actually have started development before the project. So it was a funny thing. The project hasn't started, but they have already developed a bunch of features. But then again, it went here down, 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 down. So we actually were behind the schedule. But that was kind of fine, because it's not so much compared to what was before. It was 10 times later. So now it is just 20%.
What are the fields on the y-axis?
Here, that's hours. Yes. But you can't see actual hours here. Vendor didn't show them. They asked, why would you like to see our actual hours? And the point was that they were somewhere up there. They spent a lot of time actually developing that stuff. But they didn't want to show that at that point. Okay, but here we in phase one decided, okay, fine, let's see how it goes, and it's not so bad. Then we went to the phase two. Here again, you can see in the beginning it's everything is fine, but actually it was the same thing. They have started developing the software already before the phase two started. So they showed what they have done and it was all fine. And afterwards, when they started developing something that was not done, what was not developed before, they start having issues. And everything went worse here. So it was half of time behind the schedule. Okay? So, time passed by. 2 weeks, month, months, months. As you can see, it's already sprint 23 or something in this image. And at some point, last year, last December, there was another meeting, another steering meeting. We had them every 2 weeks where the board came in. And actually, the sprints were 2 weeks as well. So, as the board didn't have trust anymore, they wanted steering meeting every 2 weeks. But anyway, we saw those blue lights, blue lines here are the plan that you saw in the very beginning. The green one are what the vendor's PM said, well, we will need an extra time of about 6 months to finish the project, and of course some extra money for that. As you can see, the phase one actually didn't finish. So the results that we saw in the slide that everything is good, they were fake. The
testing and approval of the software actually went on. So, what to do? The deadline here was quite hard. We couldn't change it. So I called one of my friends, the Agile coach, the best Agile coach I know in Latvia, and he flew in. So we sat in a few meetings, and what did he find out? What was the outcomes? First one was meetings were super, super inefficient and boring. For example, in grooming, there was one analyst sitting in front of the specification of 1,000 and reading it through, like page by page, line by line, in a monotone voice. All the business and developers were sitting around and listening to him, how he's reading the book. What do you think was the outcome? Exactly, all the answers were correct. So that was number one. The other one was transparency. Neither developers nor the business knew when they are going to deliver something. They didn't know what has been delivered, what has been tested, how much of all those epics are actually done or undone, or how far we are in those epics. So that was a big frustration for the business, because they didn't know, are we going to make the deadline or not? The plan for 6 month extra was just based on how fast we work, but we don't know what actually have we delivered. So another thing is the structure of the teams. They were still, as you can see here, that's a real structure from the team. So there was senior developer that was sitting in the groomings and in the planning, and he was planning for the junior developer who was back in the office and doing the programming. The junior developer didn't know what's happening in the real life here. Same for the business. Some people were in the meetings, and then they passed on the tasks down there. And both of the teams still had different goals. They didn't talk about the same thing. And of course, communication gap. As I told already, they don't talk about the same things. They are expressing, the product owner was expressing their needs and doubts, but the vendor and the project manager or the Scrum Master didn't actually listen to them. And he had his own opinion and his own way of thinking and doing things. So the customer opinion didn't really matter here, because the vendor knew best how to implement the software, right? That's how it should be, okay? And we did some suggestions. We made a list, what we should do, what you should improve in the process to make it better. But again, project management said, nope, I know what I'm doing, and this is okay, just follow my lead. And we got, of course, a bit confused and frustrated from the Agile coaching point of view, what should we do and suggest for this customer. As there was this pressure back, we just waited for them to fail. Basically waited to fail so they can learn their own way that it won't work. Okay, but for me, it was also doing some thinking. What happened? Why did this happen? What do you think? Why this happened? We did Scrum training, right? So the team was up and running. What went wrong? Were they sleeping during the training? Sorry? Nope, they were not sleeping during the training. Yes, we did not educate leadership team, okay. There was another one. They didn't want, maybe. Yeah, probably. Something from behind. Yeah, exactly. And how do you call it? Exactly. So what the team did, and I helped them a bit here, take the Scrum framework and put it on the way of thinking they are doing things now. So they were doing planning meetings in the same approach they did before, but just twice a week, more regularly. The plannings, they didn't do anything that they planned actually. The scope was changing all the time because they didn't do groomings normally. They did the groomings by reading the documents. They didn't know how to do the grooming, what should be done in the grooming. So
I gave the framework, but I didn't give the way of thinking, change of mind. And they continued working the old way with the different events and ceremonies. So I have created an agile cargo called Monster. But there was a problem, the deadline. It was not movable. It was not changeable because of the external factors. There was some other project that was coming on. If this would not be delivered in time, this project would make no sense and it would have to be canceled anyway. So we had to make to the deadline. And they asked for action. So in a meeting with this, in another steering meeting, the board was so frustrated, they wanted a change. They wanted to do something else. What would you do? What would you do? Maybe let's do an exercise. So find a couple and discuss 1 minute, what would you do in this situation? What would you suggest the team and the board of members to do? Okay, 1 minute. Okay. Who wants to shout out their idea? So the first one who goes has the best idea, okay? What's an idea?
Prioritize
what? So I will tell you what I did. So I asked my friend Yanis and Mix, who are great agile coaches, to come and help me. And what we did, we suggested to do kind of a restart in the project. I said, okay, let's do it the proper way. And then there was a discussion in the last steering meeting, basically. Either we go our way, the real Scrum way, or we stop the project. And Wender was thinking for 3 seconds and he said, okay, we can go your way now. So what we did, we actually had to change the project manager because the previous one was not really agile from this perspective and go on with another approach. So we tested, we did some surveys, we talked to the people and we tested how they feel, what are the pain points, what are the major pain points in the team and in the business. And we find out that they don't have a shared vision, as you know already. So they were looking in different directions from the business perspective and from the vendor perspective. They didn't have roles. The product owner was actually doing project management stuff, some command and control stuff and some other stuff because the vendor was not good in what they should be doing. Feedback. There was missing feedback from the team and from the project and from the business about are we doing well or not doing well, so how can we improve? Focus, they were doing at the moment around 10 to 15 epics at the same time. They were working on them at the same time. So basically, they were quite multitasking, let's say. So. And quality, everything delivered to the customer, to the end users, was of bad quality. So they had to do a lot of rework. So we took these and we moved on. Next activity, of course, we did some trainings again to, you know, to more about the values, about to tell about the Scrum one more time. Of course, there was some rejection. Okay, we have heard this already. Why do you tell us that we did Scrum, we were Scrum, what? But this time we did it a bit differently. And what we also did, we actually reset the backlog. We did a story mapping workshop for a few days, 2 to 3 days, I don't remember exactly. And you can see Mix in a corner, but actually there were other people in the room as well, around 10 people doing collaborating, developers, analysts, and business of all those areas, main key users, collaborating, using those specification documents as an input, but we actually threw them away afterwards. So we mapped all the functionality. During the first days, we did one wall and a bit of another wall. And then we added another piece of the wall here. It is appearing slowly because it's a lot of information, as you see. It needs time to appear. So, and then we added something else. So that was a whole story map in the very beginning. What we also did, we divided those in let's say so MVP releases. We had one MVP for pilot with a small scope, a small, let's say, functional area, which you can see here. So we put all those things in this line. Then we had another MVP for full scale go live. And then the rest, which would not be required. During the time of the project, we have reviewed this day by day, actually, week by week. This has been changing. The priorities were shifting up and down all the time because we could see from other reports and from other metrics how much can we actually do and how much can we not do, what is valuable, what is not valuable. But that's how it looked in the beginning. We put all the people also in one war room, one single room. The business developers and analysts were in single room, and this was their room walls. Well, then we did working agreements that were started during the trainings, and then we continued this on with more details through the project, quite detailed. Then we added event schedule as well. We created our Scrum board. Initially it was in Jira, then we changed it to paper because Jira proved itself not to be transparent enough for stand-ups and for other events. It was too confusing for the people, especially business. And then we had a sprint roadmap to see which functions or epics we would have each sprint. And of course, we added a risk mitigation board. So we identified some risks, and then we had some mitigation activities, and we had twice a week meeting with the board, members of the board, and discussing those risks and mitigation activities. That was huge impact, that was huge help from management that actually brought some changes into the team for us. Okay. And we put Mix, he agreed to be full-time with the team as an agile coach, as a team coach, to help them actually learn those values, learn all those events, to do them correctly on a daily basis. So, what do you think? Did it?
Yes.
Or not? It might. Could be. So, in a month or so, we had this one transformed to this one. So we actually solved the pain points. And that was our first goal, that we said to management, we can do that. And it was yes. Of course, we had some assessments for product owner, for Scrum Master, for Scrum team, maturity level in Agile, and we did those, and we could follow up what we should improve, we should not improve. So we set some goals, individual goals, so we kind of improved the team. Another thing we did, not long time ago actually, we did assessment where we measured, we asked the questions, we sent out the survey to the members of the team, and we asked how they feel about the project right now. To be simply said, so the first, if you rate one, there were 30 questions. For each question you could rate 1, 2, 3, or 4. One is not happening, I don't know what it is, kind of. Two is, yeah, maybe I've seen that happening, but I'm not sure is it really happening, or it's happening from time to time. Three, it is okay, it is going fine, we could improve there. And four is everything is perfect, it's running cool. So they had different questions about how they organize their work, what are the interactions between each other, and you can see in transparency, collaboration, customer focus, flow, and leadership, everything is more or less fine. But then there is balance. So what do you think balance is? Yes, they were overburdened with work.
The plannings didn't work. They planned too much, they worked too hard, they stayed after hours, they were working on weekends. So that's a problem actually we are still working right now to solve this, to improve this. But that was the effect in 3-4 months, I guess, of doing this coaching. So we had another success criteria for the management. First one, MVP go live 1st of April. Check, we did it. It was smooth go live, no problems. Because they actually knew what is MVP, they knew what's going to happen, they knew that this won't be a full functionality, they were ready for going live with something that can prove that the system actually can work. Other one, full scale, 1st of June, success. Of course, they were using Excel and other tools and maybe old software for solving some of the issues for some tasks. But the main stream of business processes went through the new software. And of course, it's again MVP. And they have new releases, next releases for next month to improve it. And that's the plan. And then I got some feedback from some key people, like say so. PO, it was a success. Good enough, no? Maybe. Key users, they were actually happy about what they have designed. It's not what they described before, and they even didn't know the purpose of the document they were creating. Here, they were working together, all the key users, all the business users, in one team, and actually creating and discussing every time about, is that important, not important, what could we do less? Because the backlog was big, so they had to squeeze it, and they just left the items that are really important for the business. For all of them. And the board said, board members, they were expecting it to be much more higher impact on the business. There would be much more disruption of business. So it was really good. Really good. So for me, to sum it up, the main success criteria for this project, I would say, is team with common goal. That was to set the team together and think in the same direction, why are they here and what they want to deliver. Another one would be visualization. That story map, the papers all around the room actually really helped them to see what they need to do. When they saw all the backlog visualized, they were, wow, that's a lot, right? But they could also see what exactly in each release they would put in. Of course, we did estimates and everything like that. And all the other papers, the Scrum board, we also put a display that would display information out of Jira, like statistics and everything, so they could see how they are going in a sprint. Collocation, that was a good thing, it was possible. We could put all of them in one room so they can talk on a daily basis. That was excellent. Define MVP, yes, well, if they would want to go live with all the functionality, it wouldn't work. So the MVP was a key here, and they could start the software 1st of June and adding some other stuff later. And of course, the coaching. What missed in the first approach was the coach that would be with the team, with their new team all the time and teach them and show them basically what is the agile way of thinking, what is Scrum and how should it work. And helped PO and others in the team to learn new techniques and tools on how to solve all those agile-ish and scrum-ish things. But, and I would say, talking about team, this of course was possible because of those three guys, including me, yes. So I want to say thank you to those two guys for helping on this project. And I will use the stage to congratulate you. Thank you. Could you come up? Thank you. Thank you. And you can stay here because I think now it's a good time for you to ask some questions if you have any. Yes. Yes, transparency, first of all those visualizations. Oh, yes. What about transparency? I haven't mentioned transparency. So all those visualizations are actually for transparency, so they can see what needs to be done. Of course, during all the daily procedures, all the retrospectives and plannings and
all the Scrum and Agile is all about transparency. So basically all those things and issues that were in the team, they came up in the retrospectives or in other events. But it is really important, yes. Yes. So what about transparency for business? So there were two parts for business. One was the board members. They came to all the reviews, so they saw what is delivered. They could see exactly what is the software. They asked the questions, so it was nice. Also, as I mentioned, they had twice a week stand-up about risks. So we feeded them in. What is going to happen? What are the risks? Who is going to burn out? What is, you know, other stuff? In the business side as well, what we miss from the business, which departments are not performing well. And the other part is the business itself, all the business people. So there were around 10 people involved full-time from the business, up to 10, that were allocated to this project to define all the requirements that they want and also test and approve the deliveries full-time. So that was good success as well. Not so seen in Latvia. Okay? Maybe you want to answer as well something. Maybe next question.
For the transparency, what we actually did, long story short about the transparency for the business. What we did, we created this transparency on the walls with the needed things so business could mitigate the risks before they actually becoming a problem. Before that, there is kind of meeting and we was just talking, there is that huge problem and that huge problem. With the help of these visualizations and transparency, we actually was able to foresee that this could happen in 2 or 3 weeks. So what we can do to avoid it. And that was the key in that one.
I can add from my perspective, two things that I saw were mind-blowing for the business and the board was the user story mapping. That was one. We had members, product owners, stakeholders bring people into the room and walk them through and say, hey, see, this is done, this is still in the progress, and this is how fast we're moving, this is what we're going to prioritize, not prioritize. And in reviews, actually demonstrating actually working software for the board and for the business and for all the end users. It was mind-blowing for them since they've only seen charts and PowerPoint presentations up until now. Like, oh, wow, that's how it works. This is where we are. So,
charts and PowerPoint presentations, which told we have to postpone the deadline more and more and more.
Thank you so much, and a round of applause for our speakers.